الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد. The Sahaba were the best of the Ummah. They were the best of this community. And this is in accordance with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, says. And this is in accordance to the authentic sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is in accordance with the ijma' of Ahl Sunnati wal Jama'ah, meaning the consensus of the scholars and the Ahl Sunnah and the general Muslims. All throughout time, the Muslims have held this belief and have had ijma' consensus. The only people who differ with them is the Rafida, Shia, and those other sects of Shia that have hatred for the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And in fact, when they have hatred for the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, then in fact, this is showing a type of hatred for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And in fact, this is belittling the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it cannot be considered love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And why do we say this? Because Allah tabarak wa ta'ala fi kitab al-kareem, He described the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, that they were the best of ummah, they were the best community. فَقَالَ جَلَّ ثَنَاءُهُ فِيهِمْ كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنَ الْمُنْكَرِ وَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ. Hada, this is in Surah Ali Imran, verse 110, where Allah the Almighty says about the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about them, He said, "You're the best nation. Kuntu khayran ummah ukhrijat linnas. You're the best nation that has ever come from mankind. Ta'muruna bima'ruf, that you command towards the good, command the good. Wa tanhauna 'anil munkar, and forbid the evil. And wa tu'minuna billah, and believe in Allah." So this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that Allah witnesses for them that they were the best, and that they had iman, faith, and that they commanded the good and they prohibited the evil. And Allah, this is the description of Allah the Almighty. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also describes them as the ummat al-wasat, as the middle nation, and has chosen them over mankind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran about them, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا لِتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ وَيَكُونَ الرَّسُولُ عَلَيْكُمْ شَهِيدًا. This is in Surah Al-Baqarah, Ayat 143. This is what Allah the Almighty says about the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. How is it any Shia in the world, living today or in the past, can dispute this verse of the Quran and all these and the verses we've just mentioned? That these verses were revealed to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and who was around the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Who are these verses referring to? Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and likewise, you. We made you the nation, an ummah wasat, that you were the middle nation, that you would be witnesses over mankind, and that the messenger would be over you as a witness. Who else is this? Who is this describing? Who was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam with, and who was he bearing witness over? It was his companions, radiallahu ta'ala anhum. And this is their fadila. However, the Shia Rafida, they believe that the companions are the worst of the ummah, which is the exact opposite description of what Allah the Almighty has described them with. وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ. The Sahaba, the Ansar, were the best of this nation. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions all throughout the Quran, their fada'il. وَلَا الْفُقَرَاءَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ الَّذِينَ أُخْرِجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِهِمْ وَأَمْوَالِهِمْ. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala praises them, praises the muhajirin. وَلَا الْفُقَرَاءَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ, those people who made hijrah, those who left their places of dwelling and their wealth. Who else is this describing? This is describing the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, because they made hijrah from their wealth, their family, and their property for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as is warada in a hadith that is known to all of us, where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as was narrated on Umar bin al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Abi Hafs, عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنهم قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم يقول إنما أعمال بالنيات وإنما لكل امرئ ما نوى فمن كانت هجرته إلى الله ورسوله هجرته فهجرته إلى الله ورسوله ومن كان هجرته للدنيا يصيبها أو امرأة ينكحها فهجرته إلى ما هجر إليه رواه الشيخان. In this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is well known to all of us, bi-idhnillah ta'ala, which refers to our intention. It refers to our intention. It refers to having sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And who were the most sincere of this ummah but the Sahaba, radiallahu ta'ala anhum, who the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in this hadith, was describing the hijrah, that it's such a great act of ibadah, and that everyone will get, that's for which he intended. Therefore, he who migrates for Allah and his messenger, then he is migrated for Allah and his messenger. And this is what the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in, they did. They made hijrah, which is well known, that I don't even think the Shia in their books would deny. However, they deny the fada'il, they deny the benefit, they deny the righteousness, they deny the good, they deny that these people were the best of this nation, and that these people were the people who helped and preserved the sunnah of the messenger alayhi afdhal salatu wasalam. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with all of them, and may Allah forgive us of all of our sins, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless ahlu sunnah fi kulli makan and raise up ahlu sunnah fi kulli makan. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.